Hello, I'm Fala again. Today we are going to be wiping the floors with aliens.
Hey, hi, hello everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Xcom, Long War, Despair, the Art of War mod. I'm Fala again. Today we are going to be wiping the floor with aliens in a whole new way. Some time ago, one of the viewers has suggested that I make a let's play of this mod because it's freaking awesome and right up my alley, and in fact it is. This is basically everything I ever dreamt about, but I was afraid to ask. And I was going to wait a little bit before starting the campaign because I have the XCOM 2 and XCOM and two campaigns of long war running at the same time. However, my GPU is dying and thus the XCOM 2 campaign is on hold, so might as well, right? And after I get a new one, then I'm going to just continue all of them. To keep them apart, I will be using different graphical mods to, make them visually distinct. So yeah, anyway, this mod is making tons of changes. As you can see, you don't even have the difficulties right now. We have the points that you want to put a pressure on in your game. You can either go for strategy with easier tactic game, tactics with easier strategy game, hope that is kind of a balanced and all, but we are of course going to go with despair, because there is nothing better than the devastation of everything that we love and know, right? So that's what we are going to do. And there are a couple of things that must be checked before we start the campaign. We can't go with training roulette, I wouldn't anyway, because I freaking hate it. But we have to go with red fog, itchy trigger tentacles, I have no problem with that. Green fog, again, no problem with that. Hidden potential, my favorite hidden potential, is not yet balanced and doesn't work, so we can't go with that, damn it. But we can go with dynamic war. We actually have to go with dynamic war. We have to go with aiming angles and target enrichment. That gives us more aliens. You remember, I tried to make that happen some time ago, but failed at it miserably because I suck at modding. And this little option makes that happen. So yeah, do we make any other options? I think I'm going to go with the friendly skies because I freaking hate the air game, and commander's choice because we require more minerals. Anything else? No, I think we are good for now, aren't we? Yes, we are. So, that is the way the cookie crumbles, and we are going to... what's its face? Do we want to reduce the beginner voiceover? Yes, we do, because I had enough of it. We are not going to go with Iron Man, because I'm paranoid and like to keep saves of everything. You have no idea how many times I broke a recording. In any case, I'm going to now skip this part and choose a country. So yeah, we are going to go with... we have Russia in our other campaign, so this time I may actually go with something more... I think I'm going to go with North America for a change. I never start with North America. What do we have? Aircraft and aircraft weapons cost less to purchase and maintain. Fuck me with a chainsaw, I'm reading the wrong thing. Officer training school projects cost 90% less. We have the Mount Cheyenne, we can play Stargate SG-1. And 75% reduced time to interrogations. They're just showing pictures of Hillary Clinton to the aliens until they just give up and spill the beans. I think I am going to go with the Mount Cheyenne because I like the idea of having my own Stargate team.
The drop site for this operation will be in Canada. We've picked up a local broadcast indicating alien activity within a major metropolitan area. We should get down there and eliminate any hostiles.
As you see, we are using the military camo and we are ready to engage.
Strike One, this is Central. You are free to engage all hostile contacts in the AO. Don't take any chances.
And here we are. Actually, this is my game 180. Holy shit. I play a lot of XCOM. In any case, we have first noticeable major differences right now on the screen. That is the weapons. As we see in Vince Redmond, he has a reflex rack that's the assault carbine, I believe. It is giving him a little different perk set. He has the Vigilant, which means that he has no aim penalty for reaction fire. And he is wearing a standard armor, the tactical armor, so he gets hardened, that makes him a little more resistant to critical hits. So he's our supposed tank for this mission, I guess. Rifleman Rack, on the other hand, is giving her Sentinel, that is two Overwatch shots, and Guardian, which gives her additional damage reduction, apparently. I don't really know what I'm looking at right now, but we are gonna get there. Just check out the rack on that trooper. I just had to do it. And those are the basic two things we have. I also see we have a needle grenade, we have some quick draw ability, allows reaction fire to trigger on... So basically that's the... Okay, we have the Sentinel, hardened laser sight, that's why we have the additional perk on that rookie. This is fucking awesome. So we have rookies that are actually useful, holy shit. So this guy has a medkit, so he has a field surgery, and that is awesome in case people get wounded. You know me, people are gonna get wounded and deaded. I treat my soldiers like I treat my socks. I wipe the windows with them. No, I don't. Okay, so we have anti-material charges, so that's the HE grenades, giving heat ammo to all the grenades there are. This is amazing. Okay, so yeah, what we are going to do right now is we are going to take over this little corridor right here, and in case we meet resistance, we are going to retreat and fortify alongside the benches, and take the enemies head on. Even if we do not encounter resistance, we are going to take control of the rooftop, so we get the nice aim bonuses against the aliens, and just play hit and run with them, because that's the way. I like it. So yeah.
I'm rolling.
Двигаюсь к точке.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Let us run. Oh, we have so many soldiers, holy crap. I just now noticed that we have like million soldiers. This is awesome. It makes one actually need to think about the resource management on the battlefield. I didn't think about it because I didn't count the heads. So now I don't have where to put the soldiers. Holy crap. Yeah, this is a much more realistic approach. Let's hope that the aliens come in force to fuck over my plans completely. 68, go rookie! Nice. And yeah, by the way, we are now dealing a little less damage, so that the one shooting aliens is less probable and allow us for some more tactical play. I like one shooting aliens, but can't have everything. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to set up a little bit of... I'm going to set up a little bit of an ambush with some hunkers and everything.
Got it.
And make the enemies come to me. You with the reflex go in here. Where is the guy who was hardened? There you are. Was it hardened? No, it was a quick draw. In any case, I still want to do you there. You go over here. I'm not making any sophisticated plans right now and not drawing them on the screen because I don't really feel the need to. So I think this is a pretty simple situation where we will be sending people to cut them off to the inside of the building, and simultaneously at the same time meanwhile set people on Overwatch to keep them away.
Jenna. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Yeah, I'm going to set up Overwatches and hope for the best. Only few of the aliens actually see our people, and we have the red fog active, so the wounded guy is not likely to hit our person in half cover. And we have another pod of aliens coming to join us from the side. We are surrounded. And they just entered cloak. This is just great. That's great bait, mate. I give you a rate, 8 out of 8. But we can't actually reach that guy, fuck it hell. So yeah, there are moments in life when all you can do is really toss a grenade.
Heading to that location.
And I'm not shy of doing that. Suppress this. I hope I won't kill him with that shot.
Grenade out.
There we go. That pretty much made it happen. And now we can plop a long one to break the cover of the Overwatcher so we can kill him and continue with a second HE grenade to actually... Fuck it, that didn't work. Do we want to run an Overwatch? No. I am going to, however, pin them down and hide my other team inside so they don't get patrolled in and boxed out. They are coming in for the instant. What the fuck? You're a dick game, do you know that? So the grenade didn't actually break the cover that was required to break, but broke. Oh my fucking god! Holy shit, I love this mod already. 11 crit, holy fuck! Oh, XCOM, you crazy. Okay, let's pay them back a little bit, shall we? That's how it feels. But damn, that was awesome. We are losing people left and right already. Let's wound the other guy maybe? Maybe not. Yeah, I agree. And this is indeed not good at all. Exactly as you said, yes. Those were the exact words you used. Yes. Anyway, the plan is working, however, I did not expect to have people just die like that. I mean, come the fuck on. Yeah, I'm going to flashbang the last guy. This is the first mission, so I'm not making plans. Normally, I'm going to be drawing on the screen and everything. I'm basically using this to orientate myself in what we are doing.
I feel, Commander.
So I'm improvising most of the time because I'm busy looking around what the aliens are doing, how the AI is working, so I can predict their movements with some degree of certainty. That's fine, the suppression is meaningless. It's like underwear on an arm. Just as I said. Okay, so now we can go and deal with the other patrol. I think we have the perfect position to ambush them. So I'm going to be sending half of the people to the doorway and the other ones who are the, securing the rear are now going to be the advance party to flush them out so that they take position. Then we will open the doors and fuck them. We are going to fuck them so bad they are going to call mommy and daddy. And when mommy and daddy comes, we're going to fuck them too.
Okay.
Or, alternatively, we actually see the alien before it sees us. This doesn't happen like never. But I'm going to set up Overwatch right now and just double move to make use of it, because they will most likely get flushed and that's going to make me want to utilize the advantage. No, they aren't flushed yet, that's fine. Two different pods. Good. All is good. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can stop with that music now. We know it. We know it. There are aliens. There we go. Prepare your anus. Because it's going to require some adjustments after what we are going to do to you. flush the other pod as well. Okay, there is a melt. That's cool.
Location confirmed.
Oh yeah, so we are going to proceed exactly according to the plan that we just made. I'm going to send the reflex rack guy to screw with this fucker. Holy shit, dude. You're breaking my balls. Breaking my balls. That's what the aliens do.
I think this stuff's worth it.
Sure is. It's worth more than you, you fucking rookies.
Negative damage.
Okay, we are going to lose people left and right again. I did not expect them to be on the roof. But maybe we can take care of at least one of them. There we go. Son of a bitch. Well, yeah, we are going to lose two troopers now. I like this mod a lot. We are going to, of course, be more careful in the future. I'm cool with that. This is the best we could happen. Oh yeah, eat my dick. This is gonna be bad for you, little alien. You are running away. No, you are running towards us. That's not gonna be good for you at all. Okay, so we haven't lost anybody and... Oh yeah, that's not... Oh, hello.
Damn it, the enemy's still alive.
I shit you not, game. Okay, so yeah, we are going to have to take that little rooftop. This is some serious fighting going on. I like it a lot. And with that being said, I think we can pistol fuck the other guy. Maybe not. But whatever happens, we are at the very least going to kill this guy who stands in the open right now. There we go. And let's make it rain. The rifleman rack is apparently having some penalties, I don't know. It has the overwatch penalties, I bet, but that's just the way the cookie crumbles. This is fine. And yeah, I have seen the aliens do things they don't normally do in this mission, so this is a new thing. Who doesn't have promotions yet? Okay, that is a very good coincidence. Because this is what we will do. Oh shit. Well, that's a bit of a bad situation right now. We are fine though. They have no chance. And we will get them from above next turn. But yeah, I'm not entirely happy about losing two people, but I fucked it up with that grenade over there. I didn't realize that it can break that wall and paid for it. There is another alien. Whoopsie daisy. All is well. They have concealment now, if you haven't noticed, so this is fucking awesome. I mean, how cool is that? Come on, with the little fucking sectoids have concealment now. That's just the best. I'm a masochist. And our little angel has got a promotion. So let's give the Mason another kill. Yeehaw! Poof. That's right, both legs broken, but the alien is dead.
Good work out there, Strike One.
So we lost three people.
The labs are on high alert. Teams are standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly recovered artifacts immediately.
This is fucking awesome, that's what it is. Shit, I like it. Yeah, so the aliens definitely showed me a new trick right now, and I haven't expected them to be on that rooftop, and the fact that I broken that wall is kinda bad. Plus that fucking 11 point crit out of heavy cover, that was just fucking crazy. I would call it, unbalanced and all that. We can crit for 5 while the aliens for like 12 or 11, but then again, they are fucking aliens with plasma weapons, so I like it. And we lost 3 soldiers in our first encounter with an alien civilization, but we bugged all of them and the melt canisters too, so I call it a win. The bodies of the rookies are going to be packed in little bags and sent to family, maybe with a toy, like a Happy Meal or something.
Labs. Commander to the research labs.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander.
Thanks, Bford.
I'm Central Officer Bradford.
Shut up.
My role in this project is twofold.
Shut the hell up. That's what your role in this project is. So yeah, unfortunately, I make them nationalities all to be XCOM? That didn't work.
The recovered artifacts are being unloaded, and the research team is waiting your orders. We'll get started as soon as you give the order, Commander.
We have 21 soldiers. Why are we having only 21 soldiers? Think I fucked something up. But in any case, there are 21 soldiers in the roster. We are going to buy at least 20 more because we have 800 credits for start. And yeah, I'm going to be talking all about it in the second episode when
Commander
we will be this.
Shut
the fuck up! God damn it!
Every member of the council is going to want satellite coverage, so we should plan our deployments carefully.
Okay, we're gonna have peace now. No, wait. Yeah, so yeah, I'm going to be talking about all the things that we do in the next episode when we are doing the strategic level. But I need to look around and realize what the hell is what first. However, I think that was a pretty good first mission. We lost a couple of people, so this is definitely going to be a challenging campaign, and I like it that way. And with that, I'm going to be saying thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed me getting my ass whooped by the aliens. If so, let me know in the comments, like the video, follow me on Facebook and Twitter and so on and so forth if you wanna. And remember that you can join the roster if you want. Of course, the by standard rules apply, as usual. And yeah, that's basically it. I lost 3 people on first mission, holy shit. So yeah, I've been Faleg. Thanks for watching and see ya.